And when they came to the place called the Skull, there they crucified him and the criminals, one on the right and the other on the left. But Jesus was saying, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots, dividing his garments among themselves. And the people stood by watching. And even the rulers were sneering at him, saying, "He saved others, let him save himself, if this is the Christ of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also ridiculed him, coming up to him, offering him sour wine, and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." Now there was also an inscription above him, "This is the King of the Jews." It was now about the sixth hour, and darkness came over the entire land until the ninth hour, because the sun stopped shining, and the veil of the temple was torn in two. And Jesus, crying out with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I entrust my spirit." And having said this, he died. And a man named Joseph, who was a member of the council, a good and righteous man, he had not consented to their plan in action. A man from Arimathea, a city of the Jews, who was waiting for the kingdom of God. This man went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. And he took it down and wrapped it in a linen cloth and laid him in a tomb cut into the rock where no one had ever lain. It was a preparation day, and the Sabbath was about to begin. Now the women who had come with him from Galilee followed, and they saw the tomb and how his body was laid. And then they returned and prepared spices and perfumes. And on the Sabbath day they rested, according to the command.